Hello everyone, CMeeCraft here, and welcome to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild on the Wii U. Because, you know what, I'm just too cheap to go out and buy a Switch, okay? Not to mention, there's nothing that's... my consumer decisions aren't really what you're here for, is it? You want to see Breath of the Wild. Now, before we get into this, let me just say... This video is going to have 480p video. Now, there is a good reason for that, and don't worry, that is not the case. So if you are turned off by that sort of thing, don't immediately write off this Let's Play, okay? I was supposed to have a new capture device in time to play this game with recording in full 1080p and all that sort of jazz and whatnot. But a certain online retailer, who shall not be named, did not actually get that to me. So, we are just going to have to, deal with 480p for the first episode, but trust me, future episodes will be into HD, okay? So just, I hope this, you can get through this first episode in some HD, so we can get on to more episodes together, okay? So, let's start. Press A to start. Nintendo presents The Legend of Zelda. Breath of the Wild. Someone appears to be speaking to me.
Open your eyes.
Ooh, that...
Open your eyes.
That's a lot of blue.
Wake up, Link.
Well, there's Link, I suppose. Yep. Hello. I guess we don't get to name ourselves in this game. Makes sense since this is a voice acting, but still. A bit of a shame. Which, by the way, the voice acting. Cool. And this is a very interesting room. And very interesting, like, sleeping area thing. I don't know what the deal is with that. Huh. These blue lights don't exactly strike me as, like, medieval. Okay. Oh! We've got a jump button, guys! We've got a jump button! Nice! Okay. What is this, exactly? Oh well.
That is a Sheikah slate. Take it. It will help guide you after your long slumber.
Okay. So is this like the guide character for this game? Just a little tablet device? Oh wow, it is like a tablet. Sheikah Slate, a mysterious tablet with a glowing center. You've never seen this device before, and yet there's something familiar about it. Ooh. I don't know what our origins are. Because we kind of just woke up here in this place. Oh, we've got a sprint button. Cool. So we don't have to roll around everywhere. That's good. That's good. That's nice. Okay. Oh. Ooh, some pants! Well-worn trousers. These old trousers are threadbare in spots, but they're surprisingly comfortable. The legs are a bit too short, though. Okay, open inventory is... Okay. Is it... That's the map. What was it saying open inventory was? No. I love how when he kicked the chest, though, he, like, hurt his foot. Old shirt. A thin shirt made long ago. It's coming apart at the seams, but it's better than nothing. The sleeves are a bit on the short side. Oh, we can push the box. Nice. Oh, what's this? Oh, sweet. Okay. What now to that inventory? Oh! We can whistle. Fascinating. Oh, we've got a scope. Okay. Cool. Okay, we've got a crouch function. Nice. Okay, so we've got our targeting ability. Cool. Okay. Let me just... Inventory, what was that? So, is it select the inventory? So, we're currently on map. Oh, there we go. There's our inventory, okay. We should probably get a shirt and some proper pants on. That seems good. There we go. That's better. Also, let's push this box here off the cliff, because why the heck not? Okay, we even seem to have, like, a, little thing down there that the, pink thing down at the bottom right seems to show how much noise we're making. So that, whoa, what can we pick up? Oh, just another. Oh, what can we do here? Examine.
Hold the Sheikah slate up to the pedestal. That will show you the way.
Okay. This is certainly a different opening from previous Zelda games I've played. Oh, Sheikah Slate confirmed. Although, it probably wouldn't have a super robotic voice now, would it? Some sort of mystical voice, probably. Right?
Link, you are the light. Our light. That must shine upon Hyrule once again. Now go.
Okay. Let's do this! What was our run button again? Climb. Oh, nice! We've got a climbing mechanic as well as a jumping mechanic. Something tells me this game might be a bit more vertically focused. Wow. What a nice vista. Man, I wish I was playing this in HD right now. Next episode, guys. Next episode. Ooh, who's that? Okay. Yeah, this is a very... Ooh. Yeah, I'll take the Highland Shroom, a common mushroom found near trees around Hyrule. Eat it to restore half a heart. Sweet. We still don't have any type of... Ooh, we can climb this. Nice. So, we appear to have a green stamina meter, which I presume is going to limit how much we can actually climb stuff. Okay. Oh, no! Oh, wow, we didn't take damage from that fall. Okay. I presume we probably don't have enough stamina to climb that. Ooh, mushrooms. Nice. Ooh. So we can climb that, or we could push it. Which, interestingly enough, yeah, the stamina meter actually seems pretty important, since pushing heavy objects also appears to use it. Wow. What a nice vista. This is a very nice... This Hyrule has very nice terrain. Ooh. Let us speak. Oh ho ho, well met, stranger. It's rather unusual to see another soul in these parts. Who are you? Me? I'll spare you my life story. I'm just an old fool who has lived here alone for quite some time now. What brings a bright-eyed young man like you to a place like this? Where are we? Answering a question with a question. That is fair enough. As I cannot imagine our meeting to be a simple coincidence, I shall tell you. This is the Great Plateau. According to legend, this is the birthplace of the entire kingdom of Hyrule. Oh, yeah, I definitely see the area now. That temple there, long ago, it was the site of many sacred ceremonies. Ever since the decline of the kingdom 100 years ago, it has sat abandoned in a state of decay. Yet another forgotten entity, a mere ghost of its former self. I shall be here for some time. Please let me know if I may be of service. Okay. Oh, we can take this. A baked apple. Direct heat has softened and sweetened the apple. Eat it to restore 3/4 of a heart. I beg your pardon! I do believe that is my baked apple. You can't just go about taking whatever you please. Oh, forgive me, I could not resist pulling your leg. Please help yourself. An apple and an open flame make for a sufficient treat, or succulent treat, in fact. What's this? We can take this as well. A torch. This torch will stay lit once lighted, but if you put it away, the flame will be extinguished until you light it again. Use weapon. Well then, just help yourself to the torch then. How may I ask, are you planning to use it? It's a secret. As a weapon. Innovative. However, this is probably best used to light fires. If you need a weapon, you can find something much better. Many beasts roam the land past this point. You can take my axe with you, if you please, assuming you can find it. Oh, challenge accepted. However, do not just swing it around without purpose. You must face your opponents and lock your sights on them. Okay. Where is the axe? Oh, okay, we're climbing. Oh, wow. We're just... Oh, darn. Just like a... Oh, wait, were we on fire? What?
Link. Head for the point marked on the map in your Sheikah Slate.
Okay, Sheikah Slate. That direction, but what if I don't want to go that way? I want to find this axe. Let me just climb a bit, okay? Alright, what if there's good stuff up on one of these? You know? Gotta explore all the things. Oh, what's that over there? Ooh, what have we here? Oh, oh my. Okay, hold on. Oh, no! Alright, retreat, retreat, retreat! Run, 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 run! Okay, we may want to wait for a proper weapon before we, attempt something like that again. And we're still being followed. Into the water! Here we go! Okay. Are we safe? I think we lost them. Oh. Okay, well then. We'll just keep swimming along here. Oh, we drowned. Wow. Let's not do that next time. I did not realize that's how the swimming in this game worked. Wow. Okay, where are we? Okay, we're on top of this thing. Alright, let's just go follow that whole Sheikah Stone thing. That seems reasonable to me. What the? Oh, there's the axe. A woodcutter's tool of choice for felling trees. Its formidable weight and uneven balancing make it a slow, inefficient weapon. Okay, change weapon. Got it. Wait. I don't think I got it. Hold on. Is it... Wait. Nope. There we go. Oh, there we go. Now that's a weapon. Ooh. Look at these ruins. Sweet. Cool. Ooh. Ooh, another shroom. What's this? Seared steak. Raw meats cooked over an open flame. Cooking has increased its flavor and the number of hearts it provides. Nice, we got some steak. Who knew there'd be some nice seared steak just laying around in one of those barrels. So, we're trying to get to there. Okay. Sure that's not too far off. Ooh, a Hyrule herb. This healthy herb grows abundantly in the plains of Hyrule. Cook it before eating to increase the number of hearts it restores. Nice. Oh, those guys. I see a ripe opportunity right here. Oh, this is too good. Perfect! I have to throw you. Hold on. What is it telling me to do to throw? Oh, okay, that's what it was. Didn't break it? What the heck? What? There we go. It had nothing in it, of course, but whatever. Oh, wow! A Boko Club! A crude bokoblin club made to clobber small prey. It's essentially a stick, so its durability is low. Oh, we've got weapon durability. Ooh, good to know. Some more seared steak. I should stop standing in the fire. Oh, what's this? Bokoblin horn. This severed from a bokoblin, a creature often encountered on the plains of Hyrule. It isn't edible, but it can be tossed into a stew with some somethings, I don't know, to make an elixir. Bokoblin Fang, a tooth obtained from a bokoblin. It's worn down and not very sharp, but it's still pretty hard. Cook it alongside critter, I don't know, to make an elixir. The low resolution I'm playing at is making it difficult to read some of these things. Okay, where were we going? We want to go that way. Ooh. Okay, here we go. Oh, we've got an archer. Oh, sweet. Hey! Wow, nice. Let's get this guy. Ah, nice. There we go. I don't think we have any. Oh, Boko Bow. A basic bokoblin bow made of wood. It's made by taking any tree branch and just tying a string to either end. So don't expect much. In the way of combat effectiveness. Oh, nice. Oh, an arrow. There we go. Now we have an arrow. Nice! Ha ha! We are going to the masters of bow and arrow. Oh, okay, there we go. Nice. We got some serious arrows just now. Cool. Now we have a bow, some arrows, and some weapons. Also, we're getting close to the thing we were going to. Yay! We're making good progress, guys. Maybe. I don't know. Ooh, what is this? Ooh, it's another one of these things. Nice. Okay, place the Sheikah Slate in the pedestal. Nice. Sheikah Tower activated. Please watch for falling rocks. What is happening, I wonder? Okay. Well, that's a thing. Neat. Oh, and we're at the top. Great Plateau Tower. Distilling local information. Oh, nice. Regional map extracted. Cool, so now we've got a more detailed map of this entire area here. That's nice.
You have been asleep for the past 100 years. The beast. When the beast regains its true power, this world will face its end.
Oh. That doesn't sound good. Or look good, for that matter.
You must hurry, Link.
Huh.
Before it's too late.
Well, that's vague. How am I meant to get down from here? Is this like an elevator here? I don't know. Somehow I think jumping wouldn't be a very good thing to attempt from this height. Just a guess, though. So I think I've exhausted all my options with that. What about here? Okay. I suppose we could probably drop down here. There we go. Oh. Okay, then we can drop down to the next one. Okay. Really, climbing would probably have been a better thing to do, but whatever. We're making it down. Ha! Wait, what? My, it would seem we have quite the enigma here. This towers and others just like it have erupted across the land one after another. It's almost as though a long dormant power has awoken quite suddenly. If you do not mind me asking, did anything odd occur while you were atop the tower? I heard a voice. Well now, a voice, you say? And did you happen to recognize this voice? No. I see. Well, that is unfortunate. I assume you caught sight of that atrocity enshrouding the castle. That is Calamity Ganon. 100 years ago, that vile entity brought the kingdom of Hyrule to ruin. He appeared suddenly and destroyed everything in its path. So many innocent lives were lost in its wake. For a century, the very symbol of our kingdom, Hyrule Castle, has managed to contain that evil, but just barely. There it festers, building its strength for the moment it will unleash its blight upon the land once again. It would appear that moment is fast approaching. I must ask you, courageous one, do you intend to make your way to the castle? I do. I had a feeling you would say that. Here on the isolated plateau, we are surrounded on all sides by steep cliffs with no way down. Huh. If you were to try jumping off, well, no death could be more certain or more foolish. Of course, if you had a paraglider like mine, that would be quite another story. Hand it over! Oh, certainly, why not? But there is no such thing as a free item in this world, you know. Let's see now. How about I trade it for a bit of treasure that slumbers nearby? Fine. Come, let me show you something. Well, what is it? Do you see that structure there? The one shining with the strange lights. It began glowing at the exact moment those towers rose up from the ground. I would think such a place might house some sort of treasure, wouldn't you? Treasure for the paraglider. A fair exchange, I believe. Alright, let's go. Although I will say, I mean, this is somewhat uncertain, you know? Oh. Can I swim across this distance? Surely I can, right? Okay. Here we go. Okay, please don't die. Okay, cool. We didn't die of drowning. Yay. Such wonderful architecture out here, I must say. But we are interested in this structure. The Amanau Stride. Sheikah Slate confirmed. Travel gate registered to map. Access granted. Well then. This doesn't appear to be treasure. Oh, here we go. Aim control. Some items like bows allow you to target things by tilting the gamepad. Remember to be aware of your surroundings at all times. To you who sets foot in this shrine, I am Amu Au, in the day- oh darn. Magnus Trial. Okay, this looks like it might be like the first proper dungeon area. That, or at least maybe like a mini dungeon. Alright, I think this is a great spot to end the first episode. I hope you're enjoying this. Next episode, we should be in HD. Looking forward to that. But until next time, guys, I've been CMeeCraft, and I will catch you in the next episode. Goodbye.